the wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. AS News.
AS News reporting. Andy Emilio. We're here with the legend, Iran the Blade Barkley. I gotta ask you about the Roy Jones knockout. Did you see it?
You know, I seen it, but I seen a clip of him. I mean, Roy, like I said, Roy, he's done. He should have just gave it up, you know, when he's starting to get knocked out by bumps. You know what I'm saying?
Roy still wants to keep going. How bad is that for a boxer, you know, in terms of health, you know, when you stay too long?
Well, I mean, for him, it's just the fact that in the earlier days when we was all fighting, he was getting money. You know what I'm saying? And he made a lot of money and he did well with it. So I'm just trying to figure out, what the hell is he fighting for? It's not like, yo, he need money. You know, I'm the motherfucker that need the money. You know what I'm saying? Shoot. But they pushed me out the game. You know what I'm saying? They pushed me out and won't let you back in. You know, oh, this, that, and the other.
Speaking of which, I hear James Toney is going to be auctioning off a lot of his world title belts and things like that related to financial issues. You know, is that like something from, you know, a boxer's perspective? Do you feel that empathy for him, or, you know, how is that?
No, I mean, he was another one. He had a pretty good manager. You know, he had that girl, that lady Jackie. She was managing him well. In the day he made money, he came up doing what he was doing. I don't feel sorry for him. I mean, yo, it's bad that he got to give his belts and stuff away, because that's something to do. I mean, I got rid of mine, you know what I'm saying? I had to get rid of mine. You know, I ain't making money like these guys did, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's...
Have you had a chance to watch all the recent fights like Jennings Ortiz, Kid Chocolate, Daniel Jacobs, and all that kind of stuff?
I watched a couple of them, you know what I'm saying? I watched Kid Chocolate, I watched Danny Jacobs.
What did you think of that stoppage?
He got caught, you know what I'm saying?
So, to you, it was a fair stoppage?
You know, the ref, he might have been a little too fast to stop it. But, I mean, he got caught. But he lived to, you know, do it again. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he could have really got hurt or really, you know, got it to the point where he can't even fight no more. But, you know, take the loss, just come back and try it again, man.
Now, what do you think about Pacquiao Bradley 3? Is that the fight that you want to see, or are there better fights out there?
I don't care about them. You know what I'm saying? It don't matter to me, because, you know, this is another dude. Pacquiao is like, what are you still fighting for? You own the whole fucking country. You know what I'm saying? You don't need to be fighting. You know, I'm the one that got, I make money like these guys. I mean, I make comfortable money, but everybody say, oh, you should have did with this. How you gonna tell me what to do? You know what I'm saying?
There was a lot of buzz that Wilder maybe might have faced Shannon Briggs in Brooklyn. Is that a fight you would have wanted to see, in the way he's campaigning with you with the whole Let's Go Champ thing? Or are you more happy to see Wilder still there?
Let me tell you something. I like to see Wilder. You know, I love seeing Wilder doing what he's doing. He's a champ. He's still learning. He learned a lot. He's still learning. He's still doing what he got to do. If he chooses that he want to fight Shannon Briggs and give him a payday and knock his ass off, fine. But you know that, you know, they gotta be careful of Shannon. Shannon do know how to fight. You know, Shannon do know how to fight. He ain't no, you know, you ain't gonna just walk in the park and fight him. But I believe Dante could knock him on his chin and hold him down. You know what I'm saying? And because he's kind of, he'll be slow for him, but Dante put his speed in and put his stuff together. But like I said, he don't really need that fight neither. You know, it'll be just a fight. So they'll just say, oh, so what? He fought Shannon Briggs. Who's Shannon Briggs? Big deal. You know what I'm saying?
Last question. Fantasy fight. Prime, middleweight, Iran Barkley versus Triple G. How did it go down?
Dead man.
Woo!
Triple D is a dead man. I would break that nigga's jaw.